let's talk about partitioning. So this is my computer, you see. I can go to libraries.
In the libraries, I have got documents, music, pictures, videos. These are the different folders. And if I arrange my items inside the laptop so that all pictures go here, all videos go here, all music go here, and all documents go here, then it will be easy for me to search. Why? Because I know if I have to search for a picture, I don't need to scan all the folders. If I have to search for audio, I have to go to a specific folder. So that increases my efficiency by decreasing the search time. Hive has also got support for this. Let us take an example. We are having a Hive table, and Hive table stores the daily transaction. Okay. Like all the details of the transactions on a daily basis. This is one of the very common use case of Hive. Like what was the user ID? What was the item ID? Where the purchase was made or not? That will be true or false. And what was the cost? What was the discount? So these are the different values of data present in the data file which we are receiving. And I want to know that what was the total of purchase, that is the sum of purchase, on say October 2016. I want to know this. I want to know what was the total of discount. Total means the summation. Total of discount, total discount offered on October 1st. This could be one use case. There could be like that. Or how many distinct is, again, just like pig, distinct is a function in Hive. How many different user IDs visited on September 30, 2016? Suppose these are the questions. If you closely see, the common pattern is the date. We want to take the record for some date, maybe a range of dates or maybe some specific dates. So in our use case, just imagine two scenarios. The first is we are having a Hive table, and every Hive table represents some directory of SDFS, because the content of the Hive table is stored in the SDFS directory. Every time you insert into the table, a new file is going to get created, then again new file, then again new file. And assume that you are running on a daily basis. So there a possibility is like new files will be created every day. Obviously, the size of the table is going to grow. Okay, that's fine. So the number of files are also going to increase. And if you perform a query like select sum of purchase, that is the total purchase from the whatever be the table. Table TR, that is transaction table, where purchase date, that is PURDT.
So we can write purchase date is equal to, say our date is maintained in this format, the year, then month, and then date. You see, we are searching for a specific date, but we have to scan through all the files. Our MapReduce is going to pick all the files because it does not know which file to pick and which file to skip. Obviously, in the map phase, lots of files are going to be discarded because the date will not match the condition. But again, lots of mappers are going to be invoked. So that is, I mean, we can certainly improve this. How to improve this is something like what we are going to discuss next. What we can do is, there is a directory called as a table underscore TR in the SDFS. So this is an SDFS directory. What we can do is create subdirectories inside this particular directory. So one subdirectory for every date, like one subdirectory for this date, 1st of October, one subdirectory for the 2nd of October, one subdirectory for 3rd of October. And once we do that, similarly, we can create different directories for that. And all those transactions which happened on 1st of October, that should become the files inside this directory. All those transactions which happened on 2nd of October will go inside this directory in the form of the files. Similarly, now if we have to get the total of purchase for 1st of October, then we need not to scan through all the directories. No, just scan the
files which is present inside this directory. Just scan this directory. So you will get lots of performance benefit if you see on a longer run. Just imagine 1 year is equivalent to 365 days. So scanning three just for a single date, you don't need to scan 1 year worth of data. So in this case, you can see 365 times performance gain. You are scanning through only one subdirectory, not the entire table. But again, this, first of all, this particular method or this particular approach is called as partitioning. You have to specify which column you want to use for the partitioning. Obviously, you can create levels of partition. Like if there is requirement, you can have a partition of date, and then you can, inside that date, you can have a partition of hour. That is, you want to see the hourly reports. So that is also possible. So inside every date, one more subdirectory will be there corresponding to every hour. That is fine. And needless to say that the column which is going to be used in the where clause, you should try to make partitions on the basis of that column. That is going to give you a lot of performance benefit. Is the concept of partitioning clear? What we are trying to do?
Partitioning is of two types. One type of partitioning is the static, and one type of partitioning is dynamic. In a static partitioning, and yes, the partition column
must be the last column to be specified in the Hive table. This is the kind of one design of Hive which is imposed over us. And the other type of partitioning is the dynamic partitioning.
Acadgild. Average is dead.